strength, so it's always very interesting without the water added. But we decided this whiskey, it was ready for bottling, ready for issue. So we decided that we'd launch a new product, Glenmurray 10-year-old Chardonnay. And it actually came of age at the beginning of July, so we've got it out of the cask into the bottle fairly quickly. And hopefully you will enjoy what we have. The first thing to notice is the colour. Even if you're not a great whiskey drinker, you can put whiskey into a bourbon cask, it's a nice light golden colour. You can put whiskey into a sherry cask, and it's a very deep coppery red colour. Put whiskey into a wine cask, and you're somewhere in between. A very nice straw golden colour. But bear in mind, it's only 10 years old, so that is quite a depth of colour for a whiskey of this age. The next thing to do with your whiskey is to sniff it and see what you think. If anybody's brave enough to say what they think, they can say it first before I fill your head with any of my ideas. Anybody like to venture any initial thoughts? You're never wrong. It smells of whiskey. Well, I get a bit of pear and apple coming off the whiskey, a very fruity nose to it. The Murray's traditionally sweet, so hopefully you get the sweet nose as well. The next best thing, the next thing to do obviously is taste the whiskey. Once you've nosed it, see what you think. See if it matches up to to what you think your nose is getting. Nice and fresh, I think. A little bit sweet in the tongue. With a good long finish on it, nice and spicy. I hope you find that.
Lovely nose.
The addition of water can just release a few more flavours, allow you to taste a little bit more of the whiskey. Good oak, more vanilla. Spiciness is slightly softened with the addition of water. Comments here are that it's between bourbon and sherry. It's hard to put, it's very hard to actually put a name to it. It's fairly unique. Chardonnay casks are not that widely used. They do give a lovely depth of colour. They do give quite a strong character to the whiskey, which you wouldn't necessarily expect from a white wine cask.
I'm going to go to the next one.